he knows his pedigree, and Tyrone asked him, just mention the Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu, because that's all he needs to.
And that is a beautiful, beautiful mind for him to do that. Very nice.
Wasting no time trying to get in there and mix it up is Nate Tigney, but standing on the outside of his range, a little bit tentative, trying not to get hit.
Yeah, very impressive for these guys to exchange kicks right off the bat. You know, they're both fresh. Tigney moving fast, faster than I've seen him in the past.
Well, the thing that concerns me is the lack of head movement. Oh, nice kick on the base leg. Jose De La Cruz did a good job of forcing this to the ground. And right now in good position to start working some serious jiu-jitsu here.
Yeah, De La Cruz getting his messages in Spanish right next to us here from the blue corner. And he came out with those fists, and I seen Tigney hit the floor. So I wonder how used to feeling a hit to the face he is.
Well, doing a good job looking to orbit for the back was Jose De La Cruz. Nate Tigney rolling all the wrong ways and now getting himself in trouble, getting locked up in an inverted triangle here from the top. Really tough to finish from where Jose is, but what it does is it ties up an arm and he can sit there and just start chopping away.
Very impressive to see people focusing on submissions these past two matches. It's nice to see quality groundwork here.
Well, you can see his inexperience, that's more of a pin position than it is a submission, that type of triangle. And he was trying to close it up a little bit. But now, see how that left arm of Tigney's was just hanging there?
Yeah.
Jose could have had his way with it if he had just focused on it. Instead, Tigney coming into a little bit more neutral position in the guard of Jose De La Cruz. Got to watch that neck, though. He's going to find himself in a guillotine.
Very true. De La Cruz sinking in a couple body shots to Tigney. And Tigney, I'm wondering if he knows what he's capable of from this position.
Well, I'll tell you, right now, he is giving a lot of respect to the active guard work of Jose De La Cruz. Now looking to change it up with a little ground and pound. Feels he's got those hips under control. But really nice push out and stand up, Jose De La Cruz.
Yeah, De La Cruz saying, you're not the only one who can kick here tonight. We got a couple of crowd favorites getting ready to stand and bang one more time. Here we go.
I'll tell you, De La Cruz needs to settle down just a little bit. When Tigney takes some shots at him, he sort of reacts out of emotion.
Wow, Tigney looking sloppy the way that he hit the floor. De La Cruz returning the favor on the ground and bound.
De La Cruz now in a very strong position. And, you know, Nate Tigney looks like he's just trying to turn and cover. Oh, big knee from the bottom. That's a stoppage right there.
Yeah, you heard everybody on the opposite side go, oh, you got to watch that.
I think the only reason Tyrone Gooden didn't stand him up is because that knee caught the arm of Nate Tigney.
Yep, and it looks like he's going to reset the fighters at least, turn this thing into the end of round one.
Well, Nate Tigney might have taken more of that knee than it looked like. All right, tap of the gloves, the final seconds of round one.
It's a medicine now, you know that. And that's the end of round one, y'all. Put the best words that they can in their ear. Motivation.
Well, we got half a gallon of water on the cage floor there from Jose's corner. Jose doing a great job again forcing this to the ground. He attacks that base leg with that big right leg of his.
Nate, with a little mini slam.
But you know, that was just trying to avoid going down in a heap. Jose De La Cruz absolutely in command here. Looking now, he's got what's called a chancery. If he just turns to his right and raises his right hand, he brings us right to the mat.
Yeah, we're looking at Tigney. His amateur record is 1-2.
Tigney now trying to reverse this into a guillotine of his own, but forgetting to bring the legs with him and getting himself in trouble. Nice roll through, though, and coming out on top this time.
Yes, indeed. De La Cruz on bottom. And, I mean, he was looking to control the beginning of this second round here. Tigney backed him up into his own corner. It's a smart move.
Well, Jose De La Cruz deceptively strong, absolutely using nothing but muscle to turn this around here. Now right back up to his feet. And in trouble is Tigney. He got a little bit too aggressive there. He's going to get his guard passed.
Yeah, De La Cruz looking to land a couple. Tigney trying to cover up that face. We could be seeing it.
Yeah, this may be the end of it here, Joey. Tigney needs to do more than just cover up.
Yeah, I've seen him take that position quite often throughout these first two rounds. If I had to score it, it would definitely be De La Cruz in charge for both of them.
Well, De La Cruz now looking to keep turning. If this keeps turning through, he's going to have that triangle he was so desperately fishing for at the beginning of this first round. Now shoving his arm through his Nate Tigney, absolutely taking that position away. But still in a little bit of trouble because this Jose De La Cruz can tie his shoes on the ground.
He's got an extension, no doubt about that. So Tigney trying to strike back here.
Oh, Tigney now some big shots, and Jose De La Cruz absolutely injured. And Nate Tigney pulling victory from the jaws of defeat. Absolutely no quitting him and turning this fight around, wasting no time. Smell a little bit of blood, and Jose De La Cruz taking his first loss in what was otherwise a commanding performance, Joey Ruckus.
Yes, unbelievable, very surprising victory for Tigney to connect and come out on top for that one. 3D now with two wins tonight underneath their belt.
Oh, wow, and Jose De La Cruz.
Ladies and gentlemen, your tap out comes at 2 minutes, 8 seconds of the second round for your winner by tap out due to strikes.